last class we have finished this CD test, consolidated drain test. Now we will start this consolidated undrained test or CU test. In this case, total stress is equal to U plus effective, and if you look at this stage 1 and stage 2, at the end of consolidation, that means in case of stage 1, the drainage valve is open and this U is equal to 0, means pore water pressure is equal to 0 because of drainage valve is open, and effective stress sigma b prime is equal to sigma b c. Sigma b c is nothing but your confining pressure. Sigma s c, lateral stress, is equal to sigma s c. Sigma s c prime is equal to sigma s c. During axial stress in stage 2, during axial stress the increase will be delta sigma, and at this stage this is undrained conditions. One is your consolidated, that means stage 1 this is your consolidation condition. Stage 2 it is undrained conditions. In this condition there is no drainage, that means drainage valve is going to be closed. So definitely once drainage valve is going to be closed, there will be increase in pore water pressure. So either negative or positive pore water pressure will be measured. So in that case, now this total effective stress in vertical effective stress is equal to self pressure or confining pressure plus delta sigma plus minus delta u. Delta u is your increase in increase or decrease in pore water pressure. This is your sigma 1, sigma 1 prime, and sigma h is sigma s c plus minus delta u. This is your sigma 3 prime. So at failure, that means this is the condition second stage, during axial stress increase, what will happen? Axial stress you go on increasing, increasing at failure. So there is no drainage. So it will be sigma s c, sigma s b c plus delta sigma f plus change in pore water pressure at failure. So this is your vertical and lateral stress. Now how this volume change will look? You can measure volume change sample during the consolidation, that means during consolidation compression with this compression with time, means with time you can 1 minute, 2 minute, 4 minute, 6, 8, 16, 30, 1 hour. These are all equal, means double the time interval you can measure this how much is your compression, and volume change of this sample you can plot it, that this is called your compress means consolidation graph. Now stress strain relationship during shearing, so deviatoric stress delta sigma d, it will increase with your means stress will increase with your axial strain. So you will get at the peak, you will get the deviatoric stress at failure f, and similarly axial strain also change in pore water pressure with respect to volume change versus axial strain. This is nothing but your volume change versus axial strain, and this will be your for dense sand or over consolidated clay. Now what will happen loose sand? 20% of strain, corresponding to that 20% of strain you will get the failure, that is your delta sigma d f, because in CU test particularly loose or normally consolidated clay you may not get a peak failure. The stress strain curve will increase, increase, it will continue, that you will have to wait up to 20% of, means you will take the 20% of axial strain as the failure criteria, the strain of the 20% axial strain, where it got this with respect to that, what is that stress, that is your failure point. Now, how to determine the strength parameter in case of CU test, that is means C and phi. In this case, you have to do at least, because there are two unknowns, as I say, there are two unknowns, one is C, other is your phi, at least two tests required, but it is preferred if you can do three tests. Suppose, let us say, one confining pressure, say delta sigma 3, for one confining pressure, suppose say 1 kg per cm square, you do this test and find it out what is its deviated stress and axial strain. From there you can find it out delta sigma d at failure. Then consider second one with respect to, once you get delta sigma at failure, that means you are getting sigma 1 and sigma 3. Delta sigma 3 you know, delta sigma 1 you can find it out from here. Then draw the, this is your delta sigma d at failure, so you draw the Mohr circle. For confining pressure, sigma 3 a is equal to 1 kg per cm square, let us say. Now for next step, take one more soil sample with this confining pressure, let us say 2 kg per cm square. With that you can get your failure and you can draw the second Mohr circle. Similarly, go for third one also, if possible you can go. But as I said, there are two parameters C and phi, only two Mohr circles will be enough to draw this, to get your Mohr Coulomb failure envelope. So once you draw the Mohr circle, draw a common tangent which touches both these Mohr circles, then extend it where in the intercept, that is your C, and this angle with respect to horizontal, that is your phi. Once you say this is consolidated Andren test or CU test, you can name it as phi CU, C for consolidated, U for Andren. That means it will mean that this test has been done from consolidated Andren test, and CCU is your cohesion in consolidated and Andren test. So we'll get C and phi. Now look at this effective stress failure. If you go back to earlier one, this is in terms of total stress. This is in terms of total stress. There is no measurement in case of total stress. There is no measurement of pore water pressure, change in pore water pressure or change in volume delta U. So this will be in terms of total stress. Now you can plot it for effective stress with this same graph, this Mohr Coulomb failure envelope. Once you draw in terms of total stress, now you go for effective stress. Now it will shift towards left equal amount of pore water pressure change in volume at failure. That means pore water pressure built up at till failure, how much is your pore water pressure, that is your delta U f. F is nothing but is your failure. So now it has been shifted. Now this will be your new sigma 1 prime effective principal stress, sigma 1 3 prime. This is for your first one, first Mohr circle in terms of effective stress it has been plotted. Now go to the second Mohr circle, that means this is in terms of pore water pressure, it will shift towards left. This will be my second Mohr circle. If this is your first, this is your first, this is your second, and this is your second. Now draw a tangent which will touch both the Mohr circle, means a common tangent. if I draw, it will pass somewhere else here. From there you will find it out C prime as well as phi prime. Now next step, look at here. So this is Mohr Coulomb failure envelope in terms of effective stress, that means this is C prime and phi prime. CU test strength parameters E and phi obtained from CD tests. Shear strength parameter in terms of total stresses, it is said CCU and phi CU. Now shear strength parameter in terms of effective stress, it is effective means prime. Once prime is there, C prime or phi prime, it means it denotes to effective stress. Now similarly, if it is strength parameter in case of effective stress, that means C prime will be equal to CD. That means C prime equal to CD, it will be in drain test, and phi prime is equal to phi D. CU test failure envelope for sand and normally consolidated clay, CCU and C prime is equal to 0. For sand and for normally consolidated clay, if you look at here, Mohr Coulomb failure envelope in terms of total stress. This is in terms of total stress, and this will be in terms of effective stress. In this case, it will start from origin. So C prime will be 0. Only one CU test, if you look at here, I am not doing means only one Mohr circle, that means only one test. One Mohr circle means one test. Therefore, only one CU test would be sufficient to determine this phi CU and phi prime for sand or normally consolidated clay. Some practical applications of CU analysis for clay, let us say for example, embankment construction rapidly over a soft clay deposit. This is a soft clay deposit, it is there earlier. In this case, in soft clay deposit, embankment has to be constructed, means this construction will be very rapid. So in that case, what will happen? Because there is the construction is rapid in stages, definitely there will be consolidation will occur in first stage, and stage 2 during shearing, it will be fast shearing. That means there will not be any time, or you will not get any change in pore water pressure. So this is case 1, embankment construction rapidly over a soft clay deposit. Case 2, rapid drawdown behind an earth dam. Now what is rapid drawdown? Suppose there is a water table here. Over the period of time, maybe some summer season, the water table fluctuate. That means it will come down very rapidly during summer season. So in that case, once it will come down very rapidly, still pore water pressure, there will not be any change. The pore water pressure, it is inside, it will be there. Because of rapid drawdown, there is no change in pore water pressure. So this will be again another example of consolidated undrained analysis. As I said, during summer, there is a chance that sudden drawdown will occur because of change in water table. If I change in water table, sudden drawdown, so now the failure envelope will change, it will go to the core, then this analysis will be taken as from the test of consolidated undrained test. Third example, rapid construction of an embankment on a natural slope. This is an embankment, the construction will be rapid, that means this construction is not slow enough, so that development of pore water pressure or change in volume due to water, it will occur. So because of rapid, this generation of or development of pore water pressure will not occur, so this will be Example, third example for practical application of CU analysis. Total stress parameters from CU can be used for stability problem. Remember, as I said, total stress parameter can be used for stability problem. Means the question is why this CU, CD or EU test is required, what for, where it is applicable. Suppose the soil is, as I said, suppose you want to take soil from here, and if you test it in the laboratory, what kind of test you are supposed to do and what parameter you have to give the design engineer so that they can use for analysis, they can use for analysis. So, this is the example case by case we are seeing. Once any stability analysis, this has been means particularly total stress parameter of CU test is required or may be used in terms of CCU and phi CU. Soils or soil have become fully consolidated and are at equilibrium with the existing stress state, then for some reason additional stresses are applied quickly with no drainage occurring. Now, third part is your unconsolidated undrained test or UU test. So, there are two conditions: initial specimen condition. In this case, no drainage, drainage valve will be closed. So, initial volume of the sample will be A0 into H0. So, no drainage, that means in this case sigma C is equal to sigma 3. So, specimen during shearing in stage 2, during shearing also no drainage. So, that means confining pressure sigma 3 is equal to sigma C and sigma 1 is equal to sigma 3 plus increase in stress delta sigma D. Volume of the sample during shearing A into H. Since this test is conducted under undrained conditions, so A into H is equal to A0 into H0. So, A0 and H0 is your initial volume of the sample. Then A into H or AH is the volume of the sample during shearing. Then from this, you can find it out corrected area after the shearing. It will be A0 initial area minus 1 minus EZ. 1 minus EZ is strain. EZ is your change in Z direction. Change in height during shearing, definitely it will compression will occur. So, change in height during shearing. So, strain in Z direction, if this is my Z direction, total compression is equal to say 20 mm, say at initial stage say 1 mm, so it will be percentage will be 1 by 20, this is your percentage, so 1 minus EZ. From there you can find it out corrected area and you can utilize to find it out. Once you get the corrected area, then you can find it out sigma 3 delta sigma D, you can find it out deviatoric stress. Deviatoric stress is nothing but your deviatoric load divided by area, and this will come here delta sigma D is equal to load, deviatoric load by this area. Then once you get, then sigma 3 you add it, this sigma 3 plus this, it is nothing but your sigma 1 and this is your sigma 3, all round confining pressure. Sigma 3 is nothing but sigma C, this is your confining pressure. Unconsolidated undrained UU test, step 1, immediately after sampling means before placing in the triaxial. Immediately after the sampling has been done, that means it lost your confining, that means sigma C is equal to 0. So, there is no overburden or no confining pressure, so this is 0. Step 2, after application of hydrostatic cell pressure, sigma C is equal to sigma 3, because all round confining pressure has been applied in triaxial. So, it will be sigma C is equal to sigma 3. Sigma C is equal to sigma 3, no drainage. Now, which is equal to nothing but, as there is no drainage, which is equal to nothing but delta UC. So it is, if I write it in terms of effective, so sigma 3 prime is sigma 3 minus delta UC, and sigma 3 prime here sigma 3 minus delta UC. So delta UC is nothing but your B parameter, B into delta sigma 3. Now increase in pore water pressure due to increase in cell pressure. This is nothing but increase in pore water pressure due to increase in cell pressure, and this is your increase in cell pressure. This is your Skempton pore water pressure parameter B. It has been checked whether this sample has been saturated 100% or not. If the sample is saturated 100%, then B parameter supposed to be 1, which is equal to delta U by delta sigma. That means with increase in cell pressure, suppose say initially the sample is there, cell pressure is 1, if I increase in 1 to 1.5, this supposed to be expected to increase also, change in pore water pressure also 0.5. So it should be 1, but we assume it 90%, more than 90 or 95%, we assume that if you are getting B is equal to more than 90 or 95%, at that stage we can say it will be 100% saturation. If soil is, that this is the case I said, if soil is fully saturated, then B is equal to 1, hence delta UC is equal to delta sigma 3. Now stage 3 or step 3, during application of axial load, what will happen? There is no drainage. So sigma 3 plus sigma delta sigma D is nothing but your sigma 1. If I write in terms of change in pore water pressure, so it will be delta sigma 1 sigma 3 plus delta sigma D minus delta UC plus minus UD, UC plus minus UD. So again delta UD is equal to A into delta sigma D. Delta UD is your increase in pore water pressure due to increase in deviatic stress. This is because of increase in deviatic stress, means this is particularly unconsolidated undrained test. In this case there is no drainage, there is absolutely no drainage. That means once you increase the cell pressure, you can get also increase in pore water pressure. If you increase your deviatic stress, also this increase in pore water pressure. Now increase of deviatic stress, delta sigma D is your increase of deviatic stress. This is your Skempton pore water pressure parameter A. Now combining step 2 and step 3, delta UC because of confining pressure, delta UD because of your deviatic stress, total pore water pressure increment at any stage delta U is equal to delta UC because of your confining and because of your deviatic, because of confining, because of your deviatic, and this I can write in terms of B into delta sigma 3 plus A into delta sigma D. So this is nothing but, it has been derived Skempton's pore water pressure equation, delta U is equal to B into delta sigma 3 plus A delta sigma 1 minus delta sigma 3, because if you say delta sigma 1 is equal to delta sigma 3 plus delta sigma D, once you say that, what is your deviatic stress, this will be delta sigma 1 minus delta sigma 3. So total stress is equal to effective stress plus pore water pressure U. So immediately after sampling, what will happen? This is the test procedure earlier I say, what will happen here? Immediately sampling, so it will be sigma B prime is equal to UR, sigma H 0 is equal to UR, whatever they are inside this negative pore water pressure, it will be become sigma B prime, sigma H prime. After application of cell pressure, no drainage. So suppose SR is equal to, after application of cell pressure, I can say that it is 100% saturation if B parameter is equal to 1. Then in this case sigma B prime is equal to sigma C plus UR minus 2 C sigma minus sigma C, this is nothing but UR, sigma H prime is equal to UR. Now during application of axial load, This is in case of no drainage. That means again in case of in application of axial load, there is no drainage. So in this case, it will be, this is your sigma b prime, this is your sigma h prime. Now at failure, this is at failure, you are getting sigma 1 and sigma 3 at failure. At failure, in terms of cell pressure, I have written sigma c plus delta sigma f plus u r minus sigma c minus plus delta u sigma 1 prime. Here sigma c plus u r minus sigma c minus plus delta u f is equal to sigma 3 prime. Now unconsolidated undrained test, so this is at your failure. If I write, if I plot it, sigma c prime has been, you can cancel it. Similarly, here you can cancel it. What is your conclusion in this case? In this case, this conclusion is Mohr circle in terms of effective stress do not depend on cell pressure. Mohr circle in terms of effective stresses do not depend on cell pressure. Therefore, we get only Mohr circle in terms of effective stress for different cell pressures. Mohr circle in terms of total stresses, you see, now this failure envelope will come out, it will be phi u is equal to 0. For degree of saturation on failure envelope, effect of degree of saturation on failure envelope, if you look at here, if the degree of saturation is less than 100%, then it will be there, you will be see that you can mark it a distinguished intersection bit for this degree of saturation. This is at the case of degree of saturation 100%. If it is less than 100%, how it behaves? If it is more than 100%, how it behaves? Now you come back to some practical applications of UU analysis. That means in field conditions, what are the conditions where you will prefer for this test, unconsolidated undrained test? First is your case 1, let us say example 1, embankment constructed rapidly over a soft clay deposit. That means suppose this is a soft clay deposit, you construct embankment very rapidly. That means once you construct it very rapidly, you will not get any time for your consolidation as well as any during shearing, no, there will not be any drainage. In both these steps, there will be no drainage. So this is your in situ undrained shear strength, this is called in situ undrained shear strength. Now example 2, large art dam constructed rapidly with no change in water content of soft clay. There is no change in water content in the soft clay, means in that soft clay this water content will be remain same. In that case, you will be getting undrained shear strength of clay. That means in this case you will go for UU test in the laboratory. Footing placed rapidly on clay deposit, in that case also the test, what kind of test? Suppose footing placed rapidly, that means for immediate, means for long short term conditions, what you want to go for? You will go for UU, undrained, and undrained in both consolidation as well as shearing, means there is no change in, no change in pore water pressure, no volume change because of your change in water. So in this case, you will get for footing placed in rapidly on a clay deposit, the test preferred to be UU analysis. As I say, UU test simulates the short term conditions. For short term conditions, you will go for UU test. Any construction or stability analysis, any or embankment where you go for a short term analysis, in that case you will go for UU test. So CU can be used, means undrained shear strength CU can be used as analysis of short term behavior of soil. Last one is your I explained also unconfined compression test. I have already shown in this lectures, previous lectures in the blackboard this unconfined compression test. If you look at this, how the machine looks like unconfined compression test. Here there is nothing, no confinement, no cell pressure, nothing. Only you can place the sample in the base of the pedestal, where you can apply from the vertical, you can apply devitic stress. That means the confinement sigma 3 is equal to 0. So there is no confinement, no cell is there, no water pressure has been applied. Only this vertical load or devitic stress will be applied, so that you can measure only sigma 1. Sigma 3 is equal to, in this case it will be 0. This is the test equipment for unconfined compression test. What you are supposed to get, you will get, if I go for unconfined compression test, you will get, this is your normal stress delta sigma. If I come back here, look at here, sigma 3 is equal to 0, that means there is no confinement, that means sigma 3 is equal to 0. If I want to plot this Mohr circle, that means sigma 3 is equal to 0, means it will start at origin. In this case it will be sigma 3 is equal to 0, that means if I draw the Mohr circle, this is my sigma 3. And sigma 1, whatever you will get it from stress, devitic stress versus strain, this is related to your failure. From there you will get it delta sigma f, from where you will get it sigma 1 is nothing but your delta sigma f. So this is also again 0, so it will be delta sigma f, you will get normal stress of sigma 1. And if I plot a Mohr circle, it will touch this origin, it will pass through the origin. Now draw a common tangent which is touching this your Mohr circle. So once it will touch, you will get it QU, that means undrained, means unconfined compression strength QU. So tau f is equal to, tau f is equal to sigma 1 by 2, sigma 1 by 2, which is equal to QU by 2, or which is equal to CU. So this is all about your CU, CD and UU and UC's test. Now the difference of, if I look at here in UC unconfined compression test, there is no confinement. If I go my earlier of this triaxial test equipments, look at here, this confinement comes from here in the cell. In the cell the confinement sigma 3, once again I am repeating this, once you place this sample in the base and place inside the cell, this is your triaxial cell, place inside the cell, that means this confinement, means confinement you apply confining pressure by means of water filling inside. But in case of UC test, this confinement is not completely there, this is the difference. Here you are applying sigma 3, but in UC test no sigma 3, sigma 3 is equal to 0 in case of UC test. So this is all about your triaxial shear test, about the equipment and what are the tests we are going to do, and where it is applicable, in what actual field condition the test should be applicable, all about triaxial. Then we will go next class more about your field test, other field tests which are related to dynamic property of soil, we will discuss next class.